Remember, keep voting too in our text poll. The question we're asking this morning, could the cuts actually be good for us? If you think they could, text the word vote followed by yes. If you disagree, text vote followed by no. Our text number is 81771. Text will be charged at your standard message rate. You've got about 5 minutes before the poll closes. Well, it's time now for what our three guests here thought were the big moral moments of the week. Sharon, yet another thing to have to think about if you're getting hitched. The prenup reared its head this week.
It did indeed, yes. There's been a big case about a man wanting to get more money from his millionaire wife.
Despite the fact they'd signed a prenup
absolutely,
where he had said
absolutely.
He didn't need to.
And of course the courts have now said that the prenup should be honoured and that this should actually be the case in all future situations like this. And I actually feel that this is quite a good thing, because marriage is a huge, huge commitment. And too often, you know, we go ploughing headlong into it based on our romantic feelings, and we don't actually give enough thought to the commitment that we're making to the other person, or really get to know them. And money is often the cause of so many issues within a relationship, and often the underlying cause for why relationships do break down. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to do a prenup, you're going to have to address some of those issues. You're going to have to look at how important is my money to me? How much of this am I prepared to share? If I'm going to say I give all my worldly goods, how much do I really mean this?
When people hear about prenups, they think it takes the romance out of marriage, some people. And also the fact that, is there an opportunity to change your mind? Douglas, what strikes you morally about?
There's a cartoon in one of the papers this morning of a man drunk in a bar saying to a friend, you know, we broke up over the prenup. It's a conversation I think most couples would have fairly frankly in some way anyway. I have to say, I think it enormously takes out the romance element of a relationship. Mm. I mean, the idea, I mean, if you agree that, you know, your worldly goods are shared, that's not a bad place to start. But the idea you'd divide it up before you've even made the agreement would be not a great idea.
One of the things that I do as a pastor is I give pre-marriage counselling. And it's in this environment that we tackle such things as this. Do you understand, I'll ask a couple, that as a Christian, we are saying the two become one?
Yeah. But not until you give them advice on how they should divide up their spoils if, unfortunately, they end their marriage.
I give them advice from the Bible that says wives must not leave their husbands and husbands must not divorce their wives. That's
but not
the
everybody
counsel that
has
I
a
gave.
Religious wedding.
Not everybody comes for counselling.
I do exactly the same.
I'm talking about my context, what I do. And so the prenup has no place in the counselling that
but
I have. If you're going to get into it, you're going to get into it for life.
Okay, meanwhile.
But fewer and fewer couples are actually having a religious marriage these days, they are having civil marriages. Yeah. And the fact is that divorce is on the increase. And therefore, if people are going to be getting divorced,
you
we need to protect
to have a
the children.
Okay, you can continue that debate on our website as well. Meanwhile, though, George, some religious wrangling over these yellow cartoon characters.
Hardly the most important story of the week, but the idea that the Catholic Church are laying claim to Homer Simpson and Bart Simpson as Catholics, when really, in my church, we're trying to get real people through the door.
Would you like to claim them for your own, the Simpsons?
I think that they've been described as Presby Lutherans, whatever that is. But it's a bit of a corker. In the Vatican newspaper, they've said that the Simpsons are Catholic, and they base this on a 2005 episode, one episode, where they actually went to the Jesuit priest and were considering becoming Catholics.
Have they been misinterpreted, Douglas?
Well, I don't know what it is with religious leaders and the Simpsons. If you remember, the Archbishop of Canterbury expressed himself a huge fan a while ago. I have to say, it's always, for non-believers and believers alike, I think, it's always a bit of a shame when you see the established churches, which have so much power, so much ability, so much wealth of things they can tell people, to sort of debase themselves into arguing over yellow cartoon characters.
Well, the reason they do that is that they're trying to be relevant.
Yes, and popular. Yeah. Douglas, I did promise Derek Hatton a little bit earlier on the programme we were going to discuss retirement ages, and you know, they know how to show the government how they feel about things like this. Pension age, over across the channel.
Absolutely. There are students and a familiar sight of students in Paris rioting, indeed even children at the lycée, the schools, rioting on the streets of Paris about the raising of the retirement age from 60 to 62, something which for the people in this country, I mean, it would be fantastic to think of retiring at 62, but across the channel it's unthinkable to a lot of people. I think there's a very serious point in this, though, which is that our society here and across the world has to realise the following, which is that, I mean, in Britain in recent years, 50 years ago, then you were expected to survive a few years after retirement. Now it's 20, 30, sometimes 40 years. We read this week of children being born now expecting to live routinely into their 90s. And society has a very big question to ask about its finances and about its state if people are going to spend as long in retirement as they were working, because we can't finance that.
And we have another very important question to ask on Sunday Morning Live, so I must bring that part of the programme to a close.